So let's begin with goes to late 2012 when I, Alvin and Vinith made this band Highway 69. The only objective was to make metal music and to compete in national competition as far as we can do. So in 2012 we formed this band, including Dhiraj. Dhiraj was a drummer at that time. Alvin was on the guitar, Vinith was on bass, and I'm on the vocals. And the first composition that we have ever made was Disturbed. After playing for couple of competitions, I will not say gig because gig is a concept. I will note it down like a competition solely. By playing in competitions within Jharkhand, within Ranchi, within Jamshedpur, we were just clearing up with our visions that what we have to do in forthcoming years. But due to personal commitments and different in mindset in music, or taking up a band in a different way, which led us to change couple of drummers. Not I will say couple, yeah, more than couple of drummers. Dhiraj was there, but due to some personal commitment, he has to leave his band, and then we search for a drummer. Then after Dhiraj, I think Sonal joined us. Sonal joined us, but we have also played six, seven competitions with Sonal also. After competing with within means outside in Jharkhand in nearby states, our vision was getting more broad for a competition, especially we want to go more far, more hardcore competitions, not for win or lose, just to have an experience. So after when Sonal left the band due to his personal commitment and things in which he couldn't give the time to the band, we opted for John. He was playing with a band called Virus. So at that time they were also not in a particular lineup. John was also looking for a band, for a metal band through whom he can play like that. So we approached him, so he agreed to play with us. And 2015 as a drummer he joined as a drummer. And in between, for 6 or 7 months, there was also another session drummer for us. His name was Nikhil. At that time John was not playing with us since his parents were living in other states, so he was there with them. So for 6 or 7 months Nikhil was playing with us, and competition in NIT, Trichy, and one two more competitions Nikhil have played with us. But when John when he came back into Ranchi, then we again start practicing with him. And we played major competitions with him only, and by the grace of God, we got the results out of there also. And after that, we also came to know, yeah, that this is a particular sound that we can look it for, or means in this sound we can work more enhancement for that. So after in 2017 we ended in 2017 Feb we ended with college competitions. We are done with almost all major competitions in India. College competitions, major competitions in India. So we stopped for it, in a college competition, and we are looking for more professional competition. And that time there was only one competition, there was Hornbill. So we played 2 times out there, in which first time John got the best drummer. So after that, we were thinking to get ourselves recorded, but we are looking for a studio and a studio guy, or you can say a studio engineer who can just take us out there, because we are not so up to the mark to the studio. So we were looking for some the guy who can from here, from the live sessions, he could take the procession, and he can just go to the studio and just make everything comfortable for us, that yeah, this is a thing we have to record, this is a thing we don't have to record. Actually there is a festival called Thunderstruck Festival that is organized by old members of Thunderstruck. It used to be happen in 2006, 2008, but it was stopped for some years. But in 2014 we again initiated this concert. And in 2018 we called Waterscapes Me as a headliner in that concert. So during that concert, I met with Sayan, who was the guitarist of What Skips Me. So fortunately, we just called them in like headlining Thunderstruck in 2018. So there I met with Sayan. Their drummer was, I think, a famous personality, famous drummer in India, Sambit Chatterjee, Arindam Sen, is the second guitarist. So I came to them and we just came closer about that. So we have talked lots about like recording stuff and something like that. Then 2019 we came, he just suggested me, why you guys come to Kolkata and get yourself recorded in studio. So we was very worried about that, because we have played live competitions, but we haven't been to studio where particularly exact in a click we have, the drummer have to play the same track that we are playing in a live to get the band recorded. It was very like at the first sight it was a very impossible thing for us to think also, that how can it is possible like to play live drum. So he was the person, Shayan, who was like, we were on the over the call and talking here, how can it is possible. He only just said one thing that I have, that is in my mind, and he told that, don't worry, if you guys are tight enough, you guys have practiced hard to your songs, if you are guys in your like metronome, you can do everything. So that's the thing, and the day we started practicing with everything like in a metronome with something like that, because the studio thing was because we have to like get ourselves shifted to Kolkata for like week for 5 days, and Shayan also getting his like job aside and his live engineering aside, and he have to give time to us, because he was knowing that we are a band that who haven't been to studio like big studio, like to get like self with a live drum with everything like in an appropriate manner. So that was a very huge responsibility for him also, and a huge task for us also. So we started practicing for studio, and the first site we decided to get drum first, to get recorded a drum 2019 August, yeah, it was August. After 15 August, we landed, means I and John landed in Kolkata with only with pedals. So before that, we had a huge talk with Shayan regarding the drum. So he told me that not to worry about that. We will be, he will be taking care of all the things, drums and all that cymbals. So we landed, he gave me the address of Bupler House Studio. So we in the morning like 10 we got there, and all the things was already set up, like drum was already tuned, already mic'd. Just the only thing was we have to do, like John has to do, like to put a pedal and to just to arrange its cymbal, like that's the thing we have just. And at that time when we reached, Shayan was just tuning with all the skins and all that. So first take that we take like in we started with, like he told me like chalo we start with Disturb, because it was the first song that we made. So we were like pretty much sure, okay fine, this is the first song and this is the very familiar to us because it was the first song. So we started with that, but that was a very, this time the first day was a very tough time, because we can't able to record like 30 second take also, we can't able to record, because it was a very different world, like means like having the things in the ears like guitar and playing a drum, it was a very hard for him. Like we struggled that day, like first day and the second day we struggle a lot for to record the things. But gradually when we get to the groove, and when we came to know, okay, this is the things we have to do, these are things that we don't have to do, then John also understood about the things he can do adjustment in that. So we started with the drums, and like for it takes almost 3 months, for 3 to 4 months to record drum only drums. So like by the end of the year we were done with the drums. 2020 they recorded the guitar and the like bass, but unfortunately by the end of like March it was a lockdown. So like a whole 3-4 months was almost wasted, nothing was there, like nothing to like do anything. 2020 August, when there was some leniency given to like for us citizens of India, like we can move out with restrictions. So we decided to get the vocals vocals get recorded. But before March, before lockdown, there was also like one or two session for me for recording the vocals, but it doesn't happen in such way that I thought, because for me also recording is my first recording in a studio, and that kind of studio, and like professionals with professionals, and that to be the person who is getting your vocals recorded is also a metal vocalist. Like Saurabh was doing, the vocalist of What Skips Me, for me he was doing a like recording studio for me also, especially he was doing for me. So it was a very tough time for me, because anybody to get the things recorded with a person who know everything, and he himself is a master of that. So it was a pressure or something like that also. But 2-3 sessions doesn't work for me also. I just came back from Kolkata blank, like nothing was recorded, neither like a 15 second track was also was good. So I was getting myself prepared, but unfortunately that time only this lockdown and this COVID came into act. So all the things were stopped and everything, like what the shit is going around. But we are waiting for some linearity. When government allows someone to like travel interested, we will do something like that. So I was in Odisha and rest of my members was in Ranchi. So because we need Vineet and Alvin, because in the disturb their vocals part was also there. So for vocals we are needing them also. So in August, like in the end of August 2020, when the government declared that there is some linearity, you can like move with here and out, put some restrictions, we decided that is the time, otherwise it was getting too late for us. So we decided, and at that time only few train and buses were all stopped, only few flights were there from Odisha to Kolkata. And from Ranchi there was no connectivity like that time. You can either get a pass, interstate pass, and go down to Kolkata and just come back, get yourself like tested and like something like that was there. So they decided, okay, they will go by our own vehicle to Kolkata, and from Odisha I will be landing to Kolkata. And that was a very very tough time. There's a very tough decision for us. Fortunately, we just able to land to Kolkata. Also in the studio there was much restrictions. Okay, so at that time means drum, guitar, bass, all was recorded, and vocals was left only. So when we landed to Kolkata, the day when we have to record ourselves, before that day, the night I had a call that the studio where I have to record myself, it was like totally closed from the day that we have booked. So it was a like huge thing for us, like we are in Kolkata and we have to record ourselves next day, and the studio, the government has, the West Bengal government has asked them to close totally. The song we have booked the studio was Hindustan Records is one of the oldest studio in Kolkata, where Shri R.D. Barman used to record his songs, and where Shri Rabindranath Tagore have recorded his first song. So it was a huge huge opportunity for us, but we are like, damn man, from the next day it is getting close. And so meanwhile Cheyenne arranged one home studio. It was Blue Ink Monk. It was also some of the friend studio. Actually he opened a studio in his home, so he agreed to get the things recorded. So in his studio we have recorded Disturb vocals, mine also, Vineet also, and Alvin also. So at that time we only able to record Disturb, and all dismissed to Disturb was get recorded. Then we came back to Ranchi, because the next song like Hope and don't Be the Prisoners of the Past. Yeah, Don't Be the Prisoners of the Past, the last part was also recorded in Blue Ink Studio, where we have recorded Disturb. So means like backing vocals was over in the first session after, in between the COVID. So we came back, they came back Ranchi, I came back to Odisha. Then two songs were left, and I was waiting for this one, Hindustan Records, to get open, because Sayan wants me to get myself recorded through Saurav, because I don't know, he was a great faith on Saurav because of metal songs. But yeah, so after that, when we came back in September to respective place, I have to wait for 1.5 months more. So in September, and this recording studio that Hindustan Records reopens again in between COVID. So just because we were scheduled to get in October to just release these songs. So two songs were totally left for us, like Hope and Don't Be the Prison of Past. So all the things have to be in appropriate time with accurate thing, because the studio was also just allowed to be open for 5 and 6 hours. Previously we can do all the day recording, but as per the government, they can only open for 5 or 6 hours. So for only 5 or 6 hours, I have to travel from Odisha to Kolkata, and if anything goes wrong, then it is a totally waste. So I have to prepare best to my to the level. I have to be there, and I have to get self recorded. So Saurav was he helped me a lot, in a studio. I have never thought I will able to meet people like that who can help in studio like that in this kind of situation. So within 3 or 4 days, both the songs were got recorded, Don't and this one, Hope. During lockdown, he has arranged almost guitar, bass, he have quantized all the things. So only vocals have to be placed like that. So meanwhile, we were worried about what about the video. So Sayan also through Sayan, I got touch with the boy whose name is Doni. He's a videographer in Indonesia. He just connected me to him. So just we have tell that about this video first, Disturb, because the lyrics that I was written for the Disturb, when I heard about that incident that happened in Delhi 2012, that rape case. So at that time we have written lyrics according to that, because that was the thing. But suddenly it just connected to me, and I write something about that. And at that time, towards 2012, I came with that lyrics to Alvin Naman. Alvin, this is things that I was watching yesterday. Through that, I just came with that lyrics. So he was fine. Okay, chalo, we'll try something about that. So basically, this songs was for all the rape and that we are witnessing, and that was at that time it was a huge incident, that Nirbhaya Kand. So I explained to that boy in Indonesia over the call that this is the things that we can just look it for that. So we are looking for that kind of such a video for Disturb. So he was agreed, and he was also within 10 days he just came back with the video, and just mailed me the sample of the video, and we discussed about with my members that this video will work or not, but we are fine enough. So we finalized that video, and the first song that we released was Disturb in October. Then the second song was Don't Be the Prisoners of the Past. So we have been to many stages, so we have a live clip for that. So Tarun Palkashyap, he's managing our band since when we were in the topmost edge of the competition. So Tarun Palkashyap, he suggested us that why should you guys take the live clips from there, and we can just have a video of the second song, and the meanwhile we are also running short of fund. So he suggested me, and all the boys were agree with that okay, fine, it is a good idea. So the second song in December we released Don't Be the Prisoners of the Past. Then we are waiting for the third song. Third song was the Hope. Hope was the video that we have like in 2019 itself we have just shoot down in Tarun's house only, making a local setup and like to feel like that yeah, bands playing and some people are moshing and all that. So that setup we have done in Tarun's home only, and all the things we have just like all the things were like locally, not like something like big something, like we are like okay, friends come who listen to metal and who's listening to our songs. So we call them, chalo, we will make one video about that. So and in Hope also Tarun just backed us a lot during these things. So Hope was the only song where video were shooted away before when we recorded the audio. Like in 2019 only we recorded the video, but the audio was ready in 2021. So that time only we have recorded, and it was a very difficult part for him also, because many things were changes in the audio to match in the video. But thumbs up to him, he just have done a great job with video as of us concerned. So at last when we recorded, when we watched our songs in like streaming in YouTube or listening to the songs to our songs, then we came to know like that this is a things we want to do. Like I will not say that I don't know about the vision of others, but the things that we want to, like the process that we want to get ourselves indulged was that. And we was happy with that yeah, we have indulged with that process that we are looking for, and we are with the people who getting ourselves in a process. So that is a thing we are happy about that. And like between this 9 to 10 years in our journey of a band, as a band, in between we were like in many times it was a very thing like for you can say frustration or something like that, every band getting their self recorded here and there. But at that time our mindset was clear that yeah, this is a time that we can do we can do ourselves in a live competitions, then afterwards we can sit with recordings. And we are quite happy that the first time we have recorded ourselves, and that will be the live drums, and we are pretty much happy with that. And as a result we can also see that the bands were getting more mature in practice room also, in studio also. So that is a thing we have been done, and we look forward much for it. Heaven's gone.